always asked for requests during my shows for the second part of the evening. Tonight would be no different. Last night I was playing in Sarasota Springs, Cafe Nina, a beautiful, sweet club run by beautiful, sweet people. Been going forever. Legend has it that Bob Dylan slept on the stage there. Anyway, somebody requested this song last night, and I just realized this afternoon that I forgot to do it, so I'd like to do it now. It's the best I can do. Wrote the song for my mom. She was still alive then, but she passed last year. It's about a little piece of shore that I played on in Nova Scotia when I was a kid. And same piece of shore that she played on when she was a kid, 80 years ago. We're 3 miles west of the town of Canso. It's a rough place. It's rough rocks. There's no trees, just barrens. Cold, deep water. It's not the sort of traditional idea of beautiful coastline. Anyway, one of my mom's wishes, we discussed a lot of things. She's pretty clear-eyed about stuff in her final years. And she said she wanted to have her ashes scattered on this one beach where she'd spent so many happy hours as a child with her sisters and sisters-in-law. They used to go out there when they were in their 60s and 70s, and basically at that point in their lives where they just didn't give a rat's ass what people thought of them. And it's a good place to be if you've been a wife all your life. They used to go out on picnics. They build a fire, boil a billy can, have deviled eggs, and that sort of thing. All completely naked. And they took cameras with them. And they'd bring back holiday photos. And she'd say, you know, oh, look at this, it's the funniest picture of your Aunt Betty.
No, my eyes, God damn it!
And of course, you know, 5 or 6 or 7 of them, they're lounging around on the rocks like mermaids or narwhals. These poor unsuspecting fishermen would come by in their little one-lunger boats and go putting along down the channel and out into the open water of the Chetabucto Bay and out to check their lobster pots or make a jig for some mackerel, you know, and my mom and her sisters would all be lying on the rocks, stark naked, sunning themselves. They hear the boat, they all leap up and they go, "Don't look at us, we're naked!" "No, really, don't look at us, we're naked!" You see this poor guy tying himself to the mast like Ulysses. Stuffing lobster bait into his eyes. Pictures, that's all. Anyway, my mom, she wanted her ashes scattered on that beach. And so last summer I went there and I was doing this thing. And it was solemn. And you try to sort of find out some in yourself, you know, what does this mean? And so I trekked down the shore. It's about a 2-mile trek. Some of it's pretty rough. It's amazing to me. I thought, how do these old ladies get down here? This is a tough hike. Of course, I was carrying my mom's ashes and the billy can and the jug of water and all the deviled eggs and stuff that I made to have a little ceremony. Anyway, I got there and I was looking around the beach and I thought, well, it doesn't look quite right, but you know, the storms come in the winter and they change things. So I built a fire and I made some tea. Waited around the water for a while, it was pretty damn cold. It was only August. Ice doesn't melt usually until September. And I scattered her ashes. And I came back alone. And that was that. I did it. You know, I just course, I did the thing. Anyway, I went back again in October. I was up picking cranberries for a couple of days and moving farther and farther up the shore, my quest for cranberries. And I just came over this little rise this one day, and I looked down over the rise. There was the damn beach. I'd scattered her ashes in the wrong place. I just had to laugh, you know. It's the one last thing I did disappoint her with. I could break your heart, watch the sun strike gold along the shore, where the little boats still bump and speed. They did long years before. Yeah, the harbor lights burn dim the night. They've closed these boats all down, and I'll stand in silence on the corners of the town. They stand and smoke by in these stores. They watch the cars roll by, and they stare into the distance. Hardly realize. Ah, so it's farewell the harbor, and it's farewell to the fields, farewell to deep salt water that swells beneath your keel. Someday we'll be, that we'll meet again somewhere today. All the next turn will be. On the houses, they look much the same. Well, perhaps a bit more warm. They gleam like silver. They literally were born. And the scent of pine and moss and vine. Oh yes, and rose and bay leaf too. Still spice and warm and fragrant air. Say goodbye now, you. Farewell to the fields, farewell to deep salt water, swells beneath your feet. All that's gone is gone forever. I pray someday we're in need, that we'll meet again somewhere today. Next time we'll be. I raised it to my mouth, and a sudden warm breeze stirred the air, blew up from the south. The air was sweet with blossom, the sea was salt with tears, and the sun danced on the water. I was swept back through the years. Oh, it's farewell to the harbor. It's farewell to the fields. Farewell to deep salt water. Swells beneath your keel. What's gone is gone forever. I pray someday we'll be. We'll meet again somewhere today. Or the next turn of the wheel. stamina calls for breath. Yes, and one last backward glance down by the green as Emerald Hill, where the fragile cornflowers dance. I stood once more across the ridge of that dear and familiar hill. The beating of the waves was lost like a heart forever still.